Hello viewers, until now in the Java lab tutorial we have explored 10 application programs, that is electricity bill program, time distance and currency converter, payslip program, stack edit using interface, string operations using ArrayList, abstract class, user defined exception using throw keyword, and file properties, displaying file properties, multi-threaded application, and generic programming. In today's video, we'll talk about a scientific calculator using swing concepts. The problem statement here is we need to design a calculator using event-driven programming paradigm of Java with these options like decimal manipulation and scientific manipulation we need to perform. So before getting into that, we need to understand these points, like what is AWT, swing. AWT is heavyweight and swing is lightweight. Why? Because AWT depends on the operating system. Whenever you want to create an object for a checkbox, the operating system will give those permissions and all. But in swing, everything is dependent and created within Java, which means that swing is lightweight. So this is the main difference. And AWT and swing components are more or less same. That is, we have got AWT components in swing with additional features, like added UI interfaces, added functionalities are there in swing. That is the only difference between AWT and swing. AWT is abstract window toolkit. And events, we're going to use mouse events, keyboard events, like key press, key release, those things. And layout, yes, we're going to use different layouts like border layout and grid box layout or grid layout to place all these buttons in a horizontal way. Because we are going to develop calculator, so we will be having so many buttons like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, like that. And parse double is like converting string to double. And look and feel, yes, for a nice user interface, we are going to use swing. As I said, that is the only advantage when compared to AWT, which is not there in AWT. So here, rich UI, user interface can be given using this look and feel. And yes, obviously we are going to use few methods like set visible true or set title. So these kind of methods like get text, set text, and all. So we need to understand all these things. Now let's go to NetBeans to implement this application program. Before that, if you have not subscribed yet, do subscribe my channel to get more videos like this. And now let's flip to NetBeans. Yeah, so I'll show you how to create applet first of all. The thing is, you need to go to file and new project, enter your project name. So my project name here is this is my project name, lab programs. Okay, then you can create a folder within that is, you need to right click on the source packages, new folder, you can mention the folder name. Okay, so which means I have over here my folder name is ex11. So within this folder we need to create Java file. So how to do that? Right click and go to new. Either you can use Java class. If you click on this, it will generate it will ask you to provide a class name and it will generate with a main method. But if you use japlet, you won't get a main method. Instead of that, you will be getting init, init method, right? Because in applets there is no necessary, it is not necessary to use main method. Okay, so if you are not getting these options over here, what you want to do is just go to other, click here, and so that you can see this window, which means that over here you can select J applet is for swing. So these both belongs to this JFC, that is Java Foundation class, and applet is for AWT, you can select. So once if you do this for the first time, you need to do this, then all these things will get enabled over here, so you can see all these things here. Fine. Yeah, so over here I have got three header files, that is java.awt packages and Java for swing. You need to use javax.swing, and I'm gonna use AWT event. Okay, so here this is a class name which extends jframe, that is I'm gonna use swing. If it is J, I'm gonna use swing. If it is just frame, I'm gonna use AWT. And here implements action listener. Yes, this is an interface, and I have kept this method empty. And here I have declared all the required variables like the buttons which I need, like and the you know variables which I want. And this is a constructor, and now let's go in. I'm going to create a border layout within that, a panel, and so a text box is created for entering our values. Like if you want to add something, we need to display that numbers, right? So this is the text field, and using key events, we are going to handle all these events. Like whenever you click a button number one, it is going to recognize as button number one. So before that, we need to create buttons and add all these buttons into the panel, right? So for that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a panel, and we need to add all these things in a grid layout so that we'll be getting a lot of boxes over there, so it looks nice, as similar to calculator. Okay, so now we have declared so many buttons over here, right? We just want to name it. Like I'm gonna create a button first. So this is the code for this MR. In a calculator, it is going to display MR, MC, M plus, AC, and all these things, right? And 0, 1, 2, 3. So first, just for that variable, I'm gonna assign new J button. And what should be displayed in that button? That should be given in double quotes, and add the button into the button panel, and add this one into this action listener also. So do the same for all these buttons, 1, 2, 3, and sine, cos, tan, whatever the buttons you need. You just mention all these things and add everything into that panel. Fine, the code looks lengthy, but it is simple. So now the buttons, all the buttons got created and added, right? But whenever you click on button number one, it should recognize it as one, the button as one, right? So again, we need to repeat this task. That is, if s dot, that is string, equals one, then we are going to set text, get text, that is one. Then we are going to repeat all the same steps for all other buttons. Like if it is two, then it is two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, and for if I click on AZ, it should set everything to 0, right? It will clear everything. So that is what set text double quotes, which means empty. And for if you want to calculate log values, then I'm gonna use a library that is math.log, and which is going to, for the text field, because we have only one text field, so that is what, so it is going to perform for that, right? And this is like one, divide by x, and then it is going to divide, and for exponent, math.exp, and for power, math.pow. So these are all the default methods which are available, we are going to do, we are going to set everything like this, in this way, and repeat the steps. And so it is for all these buttons. And for calculating square root, again math.sqrt, sine, math.sine, cos, tan. And here I have got a switch case, whether to add, multiply, divide, or what. And finally it is done, right? And this, so request set focus, which means that whenever you run, see now this cursor is blinking here, right? There is a field which is blinking here, so which means that we are going to set this text field to be focused. And I'm gonna perform in main method, just try this UI manager, that is dot set look and feel, and we are going to use this Windows look and feel, right, template. And here an object is created for the scientific calculator class, and we are going to set title, finally pack everything, and set visible true. That's it. So if I run this program, what happens is that I'm gonna run this file. So this is the output which you're gonna get. Okay, so you see this, it is blinking here, that is set focus because of that. And I'm gonna do 1 plus 1 equal to 2, and I'm gonna using mouse AC is 0. Even using keyboard, you can give inputs like 1, and for example, multiply by 7, that is equal to 7. So this is how the calculator works, and hope you understood this. You can play around with these options also, and if there is any exception, you can catch it, and still we can improve this. And also we can color these buttons if required, and we can do so many things with this. So this is how the basic program of this scientific calculator looks like. And let's explore the Viva questions for exercise number 10, that is generic programming. I'm gonna show you the answers for that. So these are the questions which is asked in the previous video. What is generic programming, generic class, generic method? And I request you guys to pause the video and go through all these answers. And bounded type is used for limit, for restricting. Advantages of generic programming. Yes, and the rest of the things goes like this. I request you guys to pause the video and go through all these answers. Yeah. So now let's flip to the Viva questions for the scientific calculator exercise. And these are all the questions which can be asked during Viva. And this is an important question: why AWT is heavyweight? I have given the answer also. And I'm gonna show you the answers for this task in this video itself. So these are all the answers for the Viva questions for scientific calculator. What is an event, AWT, swing, action listener. And I request you guys to pause the video and go through all these answers. And also I have given the answer for this: why AWT is heavyweight and swing is lightweight. Hope you understood this. Alright, so we have come to the end. We have got 11 problem statements. We have solved everything. And in the next upcoming videos, we are going to do a few mini projects like a traffic light signal and a brick breaker game. So these are all already available. I'm just going to explore all these projects and create how to create own notepad and how to do search and replace in the file. Basically, we are doing this one in Word document, so I'm just specifically performing that one on the file, so using a simple file concept. So stay tuned and please watch these videos also. And you can download all these source codes which I have uploaded in GitHub link. So this is the link where you can download all these source code. While downloading, don't just download, give a thumbs up and do comment. And also if you like the video, hit the like button. Do recommend with your friends. And if you have got any queries or requirements, do let me know in the comment section. Thank you and thanks for watching the video.